Good morning, children. Sairam. Today we'll continue with the grammar topic, direct and indirect speech. So without wasting time, let's start. So as we have discussed earlier, there are two ways by which the word spoken by a person can be reported to another person. So they are direct speech and indirect speech. In direct speech, we quote the actual words spoken by the person concerned. When you convert direct to indirect speech, there are some important points you have to remember. First thing, in direct speech we have inverted commas. That has to be removed in indirect speech, right? Then if the reporting verb is in the present tense, then the subordinate clause, there will be no change, right? But if the reporting verb is in the past tense, we have to change the subordinate clause, the verb has to be changed, right? According to this table given in front of you. So there are three slides which you have to remember very nicely, right? So in the direct speech, is, am changes to was in indirect speech. Was changes to had been. Go, goes changes to went. Then had or have changes to had. Do becomes did and does not, did not. Can, could, may, might. Shall, should. Will becomes would and must becomes had to. The next thing, what all changes we have to do? Yes, change regarding time words, place words and direction words. So here becomes there in indirect speech. This, that, these, those, now, then, today, that day, tonight, that night, tomorrow, next day, yesterday becomes previous day, and next year in the coming year. The next important thing you have to remember is the pronouns have to be changed. So I in the direct speech has to be changed to he or she. We becomes they, you, he, she, they. My becomes his or her. R becomes their, T-H-E-I-R. Don't write T-H-E-R-E. Don't do mistake. Then your becomes his, her, their. Then me becomes him, her. Us changes to them, you to him, her, them. Mine becomes his, hers. Ours becomes theirs. Yours becomes his, hers, or theirs. Now that you have understood what all important points you have to keep it in mind, let's start with the type of sentences. First, we'll start with interrogative or question sentence. So these are of two kinds. First one, the sentence with quotation marks begin with the question word, like who, whom, whose, what, which, when, where, why, how, etc. So when the sentence starts with these question words, this is one type. The second type is the sentence with quotation marks begins with the verb. He said to me, when are you going? He said to me, is your examination over? Now see, in the first sentence, the connective when is supplied and it has to be used in transformation, right? And in the second sentence, there is no connective supplied. So you have to use if or whether as a connector. So can you see this? Here, when is a connector, okay? That is conjunction, right? And since here is the verb, right? This is the second type of the interrogative sentence. So here, since no connective is there, you have to write if or whether. Before recasting the sentence, you must supply a proper reporting verb and change the finite verb, pronouns, time words, place words, and direction words to agree with the main clause. Thus, the sentences in the example sentences are recast into "He asked me when I was going." Okay, so "when are you going" becomes "when I was." So here, when are, that is verb was before, right? So when are you was given, but here when you write indirect, you have to change. So when I will come and the verb will come afterwards. Okay, so it becomes "he asked me when I was going," right? Then "he asked me if my examination was over." So here what has happened? Because there was "is" written there, it's verb, so you have to write if or whether. So here, "he asked me if my examination was over." In the interrogative sentence, the reporting verb is "ask" or its equivalent. So here you can write "ask" or "he inquired" also you can write. Okay. Now let's have another example. The old man asked his nephew, "Will you come with me?" So how will you make it indirect? The old man asked his nephew if he would come with him. Okay, so what are the changes we have done? Here it is written "will." Okay, it's verb. So what you have to do? If. Okay, and "will" becomes "would." So this is an example of the direction word. So here "comes" becomes "go." So remember this. After interrogative sentence, imperative sentence. Okay. In the imperative sentence, the finite verb is changed into the infinitive and hence there is no subordinate clause. The changes about pronouns, time words, etc. remain the same. The old man said to the boy, "Kindly get me a glass of water." How will you make it indirect? The old man requested the boy to get him a glass of water. So there is no subordinate clause. Here "get" becomes "to get," right? Infinitive. So what you have to remember? Be careful to use the proper reporting verb. So when the king is the speaker, use command. When the speaker is a military officer, use order. Otherwise, use ask, request, beg, entreat, etc. according to the sense of the content. When a speaker speaks in an angry mood, you can use order. See the example sentence. The master ordered his servant to learn his service. Now let's see assertive or statement sentences. In the assertive sentences, pronouns and possessive adjectives in the indirect speech are changed wherever necessary. Examples: he said, "I want to give my sister are present. How will you write indirect? He said that he wanted to give his sister a present. Here, the changes made are the direct speech is changed into indirect by making the sentence in the quotation into a subordinate clause. See to it that the subordinate clause agrees with the principal clause. So, the pronoun I is changed into he and the possessive adjective my is changed into his. Let's have another example. Teacher said to me, "You have not done your homework." In direct speech, the teacher told me that I had not done my homework. So here you see the pronoun you is changed into I and the possessive adjective your is changed into my. Next sentence, she said to me, "You appear tired." What will be the indirect? She told me that I appeared tired. So what has happened here? Here, you is changed to I. So connector, that. And simple present has turned to simple past because the reporting verb is said. Okay? Next sentence. She said, "Raj, I am going to play." Indirect speech. She told Raj that she was going to play. Now next we'll have exclamatory sentences. How to change from direct to indirect? So at the outset, you must know how to change the exclamatory sentences into the assertive form. Let's see the examples. What a huge animal the elephant is. You have exclamation mark at the end. So assertive will be, the elephant is a very huge animal, right? The exclamation is in what, which is changed into very. Next sentence, how beautiful the Taj looks. So how will you write? The Taj looks very beautiful. How is changed into very. Oh, that I wear with my father. Here, how will you write? I wish that I wear with my father. Oh is changed into wish. Now you can easily change the direct into indirect speech when the sentence is exclamatory. Next sentence, alas, the horse is dead, he said. So indirect speech will be, he exclaimed sadly that the horse was dead. Okay. How pretty I look, said the young girl. Yes, the young girl exclaimed that she looked very pretty. The boy shouted, "Hurrah, we have reached." How will you write? The boy shouted joyfully that they had reached. Next sentence, I wish I had the wings of a dove, said the pretty lady. In direct speech, the pretty lady wished that she had the wings of a dove. Okay, remember the changes what you have done, right? I had changed to that she had. The old woman cried, "Alas, I have no one to support me." Yes, indirect speech will be, the old man cried and exclaimed sadly that she had no one to support her. Okay, so you have to remove this exclamation, alas, and I have. See how it is changed. Exclaimed sadly that she had. Okay, now we have an activity from your grammar workbook, page number 33. These answers you will write it in the grammar workbook if you have. If you don't have, write it in your notebook, grammar notebook. I said to my friend, "You are not working hard enough." What will be the answer? Yes. I told my friend that he or she, you can write, was not working hard enough. Next sentence, the budding cricketer said to his coach, "I shall improve if you guide me." Think about the answer. The budding cricketer told the coach that he would improve if he is guided by him. You have to make the changes accordingly, right? Next sentence, Lalita said to me, "What do you wish to buy?" Yes. What will be the indirect speech? Got it? This is a question. Lalita asked me what I wished to buy. Yes. So said is there. So that means your simple present wish will become simple past. Wished. I said to my teacher, "Can you explain this to me tomorrow?" Yes. How will you write? Indirect speech. Got it? I asked my teacher if she could explain that to me the next day. So can is there. So you have to write either if or whether. Okay. And tomorrow is written. So it will be the next day. Right. Next sentence. Naren said to his mother, "Why can't we go to the zoo today?" Yes. What will be the indirect speech? Naren asked his mother why they couldn't go to the zoo that day. Today will become that day. Next sentence. I said to Lena, "Help me in cleaning this room." Yes. Make indirect speech. I asked, or you can write I told, or you can write I requested Lena to help me in cleaning that room. You can write anything, okay? Then the teacher said to the pupils, "Do not go out in the rain." Yes, what will be the answer? The teacher advised the pupils not to go out into the rain. He said, "I am going for a walk with you." Come on, think about the answer. He said that he was coming for a walk with me. See the changes. Okay. Going has become coming. Okay. So, I am going, present continuous is becoming past continuous. So, I change to he. Okay. And you change to me. She said to her friend, "I lost my pen yesterday." Yes. What will be the indirect speech? Think. She told her friend that she had lost her pen the previous day. Yes. So, I changes to she, and then yesterday, the previous day. Right? The boys shouted, "Hurrah, we have reached." What will you write? The boys shouted joyfully that they have reached. Okay? The girl said, "What a pleasant day." Yes? How will you make it in direct speech? The girl exclaimed that it was a very pleasant day. Sam said, "Did I sing well?" How will you make it in direct speech? Sam asked, you can write inquired or questioned. You can write, because here did is given. verb. So you can write if, or you can write whether he sang well. Saroj said, please tell me the meaning of this word. Yes, think about the answer. Saroj requested her to tell the meaning of that word. Okay, so please is given, so you have to write requested. Remember what reporting verb you will write. And here, so because it is imperative sentence, you have to write, you have to make it infinitive. Okay, so the finite verb tell, you have to make it infinitive. So to tell. Okay, the monitor said, stand up on the bench. Again imperative sentence. Yes, what will you write? Think about the answer. The monitor ordered to stand up on the bench. Okay, so he has ordered, right? So monitor ordered to stand, imperative sentence. You have to make it infinitive, right? How pretty you are, said the fox to the nightingale. Yes, what will be the answer? The fox exclaimed that the nightingale was very pretty. With this, we come to the end of today's session. I hope you have understood. Whatever we have discussed earlier, that also you have to keep it in mind and write the answers in the grammar workbook. Okay? Again, I am telling you, if you don't have, you write it in the notebook. That's all for today. Thank you. Have a nice day.